Hi guys, and welcome to another video. Now, in this video, we're going to be covering the new YouTube layout, because a lot of people seem to freak out when these things change, and I know a lot of people are going to just hate it right off the bat, because change is something that nobody likes. So, I'm going to just walk you through it and kind of show you what it's all about. I'll try not to offer too many opinions on it, although there are a couple things that I will let you know I like or dislike. So the first thing you're going to see is this here, which is kind of like the old layout and kind of not, because you can't actually choose like what shows up here. Everything is just going to show up here. And it's really frustrating. Actually, no, so not everything shows up here. It'll actually skip things that it doesn't think you're going to want to watch. And it also adds in things that don't make any sense. Like sometimes it'll show in here people that I'm not even subscribed to, and that's frustrating. But I'm not going to go too much into that. This is basically what you're going to see. You're going to see all kinds of stuff. I don't care about that. So generally what you're going to do when you get to this page is you're going to switch over to My Subscriptions, because that's where the more relevant information is. And again, you see a bunch of crap that most of the time people don't really care to look at. So generally you switch here to Uploads Only. Now, it's really frustrating that you have to switch from All Activity to Uploads Only, but you can actually change it to where that does only show uploads. So if you click here on Manage Subscriptions, you can also click... Oh, you can't click that anymore. Never mind. Okay, you have to click here. Oh, no, you can click here as well. So these two are the same. So I'm going to click this one. And you'll see I have, like, all these people I'm subscribed to. And you can see there's a couple checkboxes. So I can have it to where I get new emails when someone uploads a video. And I can also make it to where only their uploads show up. And you can actually do this for everyone. So if I wanted to make it to where nobody, or the only thing that I see is uploads in my subscriptions here, I can check this box here, and then I can hit here. Oh no, sorry, here actions, and then I click show uploads only. Okay, so it takes a second because it's got to go through each one and apply that, and you'll see I actually am subscribed to like 400 people. So there's like 100 per page, I want to say, because I have 4 pages. So anyway, we have to wait for this to update. Usually it doesn't take this long, so I'm going to try. I'm just going to go back to it. Oh, no, there we go. So it just applied. Now, you'll see some, for whatever reason, it doesn't apply to all of them every time. Like, sometimes it'll apply to all, sometimes it doesn't. So you have to go through again and do that again. So it's kind of weird, kind of buggy. Again, really slow in my experience. So then you just go to page 2, and for most people this isn't going to be a huge issue, but because I have a ton of people that I'm subscribed to, 393, like, most people are subscribed to like 100, right? So it's a little bit different for someone that has a lot of subscribers, and that's why I'm only doing uploads. Like, if I saw everything, I would refresh my YouTube page, and, like, every minute there'd be something new. There's just too much going on, so I need it to be uploads only. So, basically, you just go through and do this, and I'm gonna go ahead and save the rest of this for later, but, once you finish this, finish applying it on everyone you're subscribed to, you'll only see their uploads, which is nice. So, most people, I think, it's a good idea to go through and do this for all of your people you're subscribed to, because then when you go back to My Subscriptions, now you're still going to see some of these because I didn't apply it to all the people I'm subscribed to, but you'll make it to where this, even though there's All Activity and Uploads Only, because they're all Uploads Only, they're just going to show that. Another cool thing that I really do like is for each thing that pops up in your feed, like say this thing was a video that someone uploaded, and I already watched the video and I don't really care to look at it again, I can hide that activity. And so now when I go back to My Subscriptions, it doesn't show up anymore. Oh, what the hell? Hang on. It normally doesn't. What the hell? Hang on, let's try this again. Kind of buggy. All right, hide that activity. Let's try going to Uploads Only and then switching back. Okay, well, that doesn't work anymore. So you used to be able to hide activity like that. They might fix it to where you can. This just launched today, I'm imagining. So it should, that's weird. It worked before for me. So anyway, And if you do actually read up on the different things that people do, like commenting and liking videos and stuff, then go ahead and leave it the way it is, because you can actually switch over to the uploads only here. I don't think it's too big of an issue. I really do like the new layout overall. One of the things that I really don't like, though, is this giant, look at this amount of white space here. Like, I mean, it's all right, but man, I've got a big monitor, you know? Like, what am I supposed to do with all this? You know, it's a huge waste of space. Like I could throw YouTube on its window here, and all of this is just wasted space. I mean, obviously, if I was running another application, it'd be all right. But man, that's frustrating. So let's go ahead and we're gonna click on a video. Let's go ahead and click on this video, and I'm gonna pause it right away. Because there's a bunch of stuff here. Now, it's going to seem pretty familiar to you guys, so I'm not going to go over it too in detail. So I'm just going to click get. Oh, what is this? Oh, needy. Okay, so this is an interesting little thing here. That's new. Hello. Oh, goodness. All right. So here we are. We're on a video, and it's different, right? So the title is no longer at the top of the video, it's now below it. You don't get, like, I have a little label on my name. You don't get the labels anymore. They don't show up anymore. You know, the little, I don't know, like the little thing that people put. I don't even remember what it's called. But anyway, there's like a label that normally you would get. That doesn't show up anymore, so that's frustrating. And everything else is kind of the same. The likes and dislikes, if you look here, the bar is green, so if I like it, the bar is going to just stay green. I'm going to dislike it real quick. I think I need to refresh. I'm going to dislike it real quick. Okay, yeah, now you can see how the dislike bar, someone disliked it, it wasn't me. Oops. Okay, yeah, it definitely wasn't me that disliked it, but you can see the bar is gray instead of red, and I think that's, they're kind of trying to take out the negativity of dislikes. Like, even when you hover over this, it's not red, so that's interesting. Now, here's another thing. Now, the comment section is definitely different. You can see that it shows people's little avatars or whatever, and I really don't like that. Like, what is the point of the avatars? I don't get it. So, there's that, and the other than that, I mean, it's really similar. You can, of course, report. Oh, okay, so you can report the profile image, and you can flag for spam like you've always been able to do. In my experience, it's not any faster or anything, like the auto updates and stuff are still the same. Everything else here is basically identical. Now, another thing that is changed, let me go ahead and go to my channel. Because my channel looks the same, right? But let's go to a playlist. Oh yeah, here we go, Hermitcraft. That sounds good. Okay, so you'll see when we go to a playlist, it doesn't actually take us to a playlist page anymore. It's actually just a playlist, and you can see here's the playlist title, and here's the author of the playlist. You can see skip forward and back. You can have autoplay and shuffle. So shuffle's not too useful for me, but for a lot of people, I can imagine it could be, because you can create a music playlist, put it on shuffle, and there you go. The autoplay is pretty neat for that sort of thing as well. And if we scroll here, we can actually choose which episode we want to watch. So, like, say I left off on episode 17, I can click on that. I can watch it through, right? I can watch it through all the way to the end. And once the video ends,
if you did enjoy it, go ahead and leave a rating. And until next time, I will see you guys later.
Once the video ends, it skips right to the next video, which is really cool. This is way better than their stupid bottom bar that they had before. I really like this this playlist layout. It's really, really cool. It's going to really encourage people to use playlists as well, I think. And even when you go into full screen, the playlist capabilities are still here. You can still skip to the next video. I mean, it's really nice compared to the way it used to be. And yeah, that's basically it. Now, you do have this guide thing on the left-hand side, but it's really stupid in my opinion, because, like, say I want to go back to that My Subscriptions page. When I click on it, it takes me back to my home page. So it's like, why don't I just click home to get there? But I mean, other than that, it's pretty neat. It'll work for most people. And again, I think a lot of people are going to overreact to it, but it's really something that's not too different from the previous version. And it's not really that bad of a change. I really do enjoy a lot of the features. Again, the fact that they took away my little video title thing on my page, I don't like. And there actually is a new feature that I do like. So if you go here, youtube.com/feed/ The Jassassin. Oh, they pulled that out. Okay, so that used to take you to a feed of all my videos to where you didn't have to go to my channel page to get to it. So let's see. How do you actually get to that? I thought you could do that. Okay, so they removed it. It used to look just like this. But it looks like there's just a random code in there now instead of the username. So that kind of sucks. But either way, it's pretty neat. The only other thing that I want to show you, let's go here. Is this what I want to do? Okay, so you can subscribe to people in these related channels, which is, it's pretty neat the way subscribing works now. It kind of shows you what's going on, and it also, like, it feels like it encourages you to subscribe to people more frequently. And I really like that. It's a lot easier to subscribe to someone, and it's not as crazy. If you're wondering about this video, I'll link it in the description. I feel like I'm going to get a couple comments on that. It's pretty good. Also, if you guys do not have the new layout yet, which I have a feeling a couple people might, because it took me a second to actually figure it out, because I've been switched on and off of it the whole time it's been in testing. So if you don't have it, hit F12 on your keyboard if you're running Google Chrome, and there's this code in the description. You just copy this code and paste it in here. Control V and hit enter, and it takes a second, and it's going to say undefined and do a bunch of that. And then when you go back to the YouTube homepage, you should see the new layout. So I'll put that code in the description. I have a feeling most people are already going to be on the layout, but if you're not, that'll get you on it, and it should be permanent. It shouldn't go away when you restart your browser. So that's basically it. That's all I want to go over. So I want to thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and leave a rating, and until next time, I will see you guys.